What's up, everyone? Welcome back to Zerg Cheese 2 Rank 1. In the last episode, I might have gone a little bit too crazy by trying to corrupt your cheese as Zerg, but it was a lot of fun. For today, I'm going to make some more crazy cheeses work. Hopefully work, like Ultralisk, maybe some Swarmost, actually. I wanted to say Infestors, but I did have some bad experiences with it as well. Doesn't usually stop me, though. Let's begin. The first game of the day is a ZVZ. Dude, I just checked my statistics and we play ZVZ the most of the time by far. And it's also the only matchup that we have lost games in this season. Not in like the entire show, but since the new season started, which was I think about 4 episodes ago or something like that. We haven't lost a single game to Protoss and Terran, I believe, but we have lost 3 times against Zerg. So I guess it makes sense, right? Because it's so hard to make the crazy stuff that I like to do work in a mirror matchup. Now, normal cheeses in ZVZ are pretty good. I mean, most Zergs play very cheesy in ZVZ, including the best players in the world. Not necessarily the cheeses I would do, but like some very, you know, well-timed roach aggression with Banelings or with plus one or something like that. But the stuff that I like to do, Raptor Rush, for example, it's pretty hard, guys. It's pretty hard to make it work, I promise. Now, what should I do? I kind of feel like making some Hydras in ZVZ. Like, in these last couple episodes, if you guys missed the last one, this is going to be very close to the end of Zerg to Grandmaster. After this one, I'm going to do either 1 or 2 more episodes, I think. Unless I somehow get inspired and do 3 more or whatever, but we'll see. It's only going to be a couple more. I really want to make sure that I do all the things that I want to do and all the things I enjoy doing throughout this show. And one of them is definitely Hydras. We owned a Terran with it. Was it? I think we owned a Terran with it in the last episode. And against Zerg, I mean, it's one of those builds that shouldn't work, but it has been working a surprising amount for us, so I guess we might as well give it another shot. So what I'm going to do is I'll open with the classic Link Drop build. I'm not necessarily going to go for the Link Drop, but I'm going to give myself the opportunity to if I want to. And then I'm going to go into Hydralisk after. I didn't really like the idea of going Zergling Hydra in ZVZ, because what I had in my mind was most people play roaches in a macro game, right? And then you can surround the roaches with the links and have like the glass cannon, super high DPS of the Hydra, just pop off and shoot those units for free. The problem is that it's very expensive. Roaches are a lot cheaper and most likely you'll just die to someone making mass roaches. But I do like the dream, so I guess we'll see if we can make that one work. Now, that should have been a set of Zerglings, by the way. That's a small mistake by me. It's a little unfortunate, but not the biggest deal. Make sure I put my Overlords in good position. Wait, who the hell sends Overlords to the main base? That feels a little crazy. Why the hell are you guys going there? I mean, it's because I told them to. Don't forget about that, guys. It wasn't me, okay, I promise. They were just, rebelling. That was the word I was looking for. They were rebelling against me. Now, I do think, yeah, that's the amount of drones that I want. I haven't seen a wall off or a third base yet, I believe. I could send my overlords together. I also don't really want to risk going for a link drop if my opponent is one of those Zergs that, you know, doesn't wall off and just lingolins me instead, because we've had some bad experiences in that situation. Okay, there's a Roach Warren there, and that is the... I like that. That's the first sign of a wall off. Wait, I wonder if I can get him with this. I think my Zerglings are going to be a little too slow, right? And this map is just a little too big, I believe. Oh, no. It is so freaking close. Wait, can I block them? No, I barely couldn't. But I am going to be able to get these queens, I think. Like, I have a lot more links on the way, guys. Here we go. I'm going to get these Zerglings first of all. He also has a surprising amount of Zerglings, I have to say. Let's see. Can I still get in there? I'm going to make this a link drop anywhere, drop overlord anyway. Just in case. And then I think I can fight, but I'm not 100% sure that's a thing. I think I can fight, though. Let's see if I can take down the Zerglings and then run away. Exactly. I think this was pretty decent, because now I can drop in his main, and this is not going to be something that he's going to see coming. Let's see. Going to make an extra gas here as well. I need to just drone up this base entirely. That's basically the plan. Okay, let's see. He's not going to see this one coming, so here we are going to be able to make a little bit of a difference. Going to get Hydra speed, a third... what's it called? A third thingy. A third gas, that's what I was getting. Here we go, we're going to be able to go a couple of those, send those Zerglings back into there as well. Let's see, I'm going to target that one, make sure to save this overlord. Now I'm going to get a couple ones over here. He looks like he is planning to attack me with roaches, right? Like, he doesn't have a lot of drones there at all. Let me kill another one of those. Yeah, this kind of starting to feel like an all-in a little bit here. Am I going to lose that overlord? Oh, I'm going to lose the overlord because it's not far enough. Let me quickly make the amount of... Oh, no, it's not going to die. Oh, well, I guess I... Usually I underestimate the queen, even though I know that it's absolutely fantastic. Well, this time I guess I overestimated the queen a little bit. Gonna make one creep tumor over here. And now we just have to, like, we're certain that our opponent's coming across the map. Let's see if her Hydra build is good enough to defend. Like, the Hydras are gonna be so freaking good, but I haven't made that many yet. There we go, the first Hydra is out. I think I have three on the way. Here, more and more Hydras. I mean, I'm really sure that he's gonna try to attack me with these roaches. Exactly, at least, you know, he should. Here we go. Oh, maybe this is gonna be a nice surround. Gonna be able to get a couple links here already. Like, the Hydras have good range, of course. I also do have the range upgrade, or the movement speed upgrade here. Let's see, let's just do the Hydras, all the damage here. Yeah, the Hydras are gonna pop off if I can keep them away from the roaches. Look at this. Yeah, the Hydras are getting to do so much damage here, guys. They're shooting everything for free. I do have to keep microing these. He doesn't have speed on these roaches. Keep that in mind. Oh my god, we've had this only once before. I forgot that you can do this. You can kite the roaches with the Hydras. They're doing so much freaking damage. And there we go. I'm gonna keep a bunch of these alive. Our opponent does not have a lair yet. And somehow I still have... what was that? 34 drones? That is really not bad at all. And now I'm going to be able to go across the map. He was still sending roaches. And there we go. All right, guys. The link drop into the Hydra defense. Now, I'm kind of surprised that we were in a decent spot, to be fair. Like, if we look at it, I guess maybe the Hydras are just good enough on the defense. Because if we look at the supply here, guys, we are down by 6 supply and up by 9 drones. That means my opponent has way more army. I mean, he has 8 roaches against 0 roach / Hydra units. But I guess since the Hydras are not that easy to catch, once you get the speed upgrade, which I did, makes them pretty good on the defense. I also could have gotten range, but then they would have died a little bit easier to the roaches chasing them. And this was really not bad. I mean, a lot of the damage I did was also quite important. Like, it's not that much damage. I think in the end, I want to guess that I probably killed about 6 drones. I mean, these also bought a lot of time for me, but this was a really cool warm-up game. Let's go to game number 2. All right, game number 2 is going to be against a Terran. Hey, that's Lema. I think we played against him in the last Mothership Rush episode. I think it was the... yeah, it was the absolutely brutal game. I remember it. It was the absolutely brutal game where he was in, like... He was pretty far ahead, and then I recalled into his base, and it's... well, yeah, I mean, you just have to see it. I can't even describe how freaking brutal that was. Now, what am I going to do against him? Because we've already done Hydras against Terran in these last couple episodes, right? Or, like, these last final episodes, I should say. We did it in the last Zerg Cheese episode. I'm still going to open with 17-17 because that is just an absolute vibe. Like, I really like the outplay potential that it gives us with the link drops and stuff, right? Like, that is just absolutely awesome. So I'm going to keep doing that. I wouldn't mind going for, like, a Lurker Cheese as well. But I think usually the early games are a little too hectic to be able to do that. And I do have to admit, even though the Lurker is one of the absolute best units in ZVT, it is mostly so in the late game when you get, like, the hive upgrades. Now, I can't really be doing a cheese and get a hive and get upgrades from the hive and then somehow not be dead. I mean, I have done a couple ultra rushes before. I could consider doing an ultralis rush here. The thing is, I remember how he played against our Protoss. He did a very early cyclone into, like, some mass Widowmine drop shenanigans into just... oh, I need to send a drone already. Into, like, more Cyclones. And I feel like... I mentioned this before. Against Cyclones, the best way to deal with them is either to make Hydras, like we did in the last episode, because they just shred them, or you play kind of normal. It's not the best to play cheesy. Like, that's kind of the reason why I would make a Cyclone. If I play against a cheesy Zerg, I think it'd be pretty good to make a couple Cyclones to defend the attack. Like, probably not more than 2. But still... could definitely help. So if I want to go for something like an Ultralisk rush, even if I get the Ultralisk out, which I probably should be able to if I, you know, really get a good defense going on with maybe like an early spine or something, it's still not going to be that great against an army of Cyclones, right? So I guess we're going to have to see. I do think the Ultralisk have potential against the Cyclones, but it's just going to be a lot harder to make it work. I guess we'll see. Maybe I'll still feel like making Ultras anyway. So he is going for a normal expansion. That's great. He went for a Reaper as well. So that is good to know. I guess I'll send the Lynx over here. Yeah, I'm going to just try to counterattack with the Lynx a little bit. Going to make 2 more drones, I believe. Let's see. Where is the Reaper? I'm not quite sure if the Reaper has passed already, so I'll just go up here first. I could have, like, gone straight, but maybe the Reaper was still there. So here is Mr. Reaper. Then I'm going to send these Lynx across. These Lynx are pretty much just meant to...
annoy him for the most part. Like, I want to try and attack his command center, or attack the SCV that finished the command center, rather. I'm not going to be in time to deny that, I think. Or, I mean, I say that. Oh, the SCV is on the other side, though. If the SCV wasn't on the other side, I think it would have died in time, actually. But okay, that is pretty fortunate for him then. Oh, we're even going to get inside the base. This is very, very nice. We're even going to get the Marine here, I think, because he's not pulling enough SCVs. You are not taking me seriously enough, Mr. Lamo. I have a feeling he's going to try to switch these. Yeah, exactly. Can I make it? Oh, it's going to be close. Yeah, speed finished. Oh, no. That is brutal. Can I block it for as long? He's trying to land it. Look. Oh my god, no. Yeah, this is actually so freaking brutal right now. Look at this. No, he got it finally. Dude, that was a very long block. And he made a pretty typical mistake, guys, which is to launch the mules on the natural. So he is going to be losing about 300 minerals worth of mules here instantly. And that is very painful. And the Reaper. And oh my goodness, this is the best start we could have ever had. I mean, I still want to see what is coming out of those... what's it called? I still want to see... Wait, did I swear I made an infestation pit. Did I click the thing away? I guess I must have. I also have no idea what happened. I still want to see what's going to come out of that factory, right? Like, is it going to be Cyclones or Hellions or... Oh, that looked like a... Yeah, okay, it is a Cyclone. Right, so... Well, I think we're just going to go for it. Like, I did say it was going to be crazy against Cyclones, but I'm still just going to go for it. It does suck a little bit for us that that Infestation Pit didn't build. I must have just clicked the... the drone away on accident, or maybe it was blocked or something. So that is going to delay my hive a little. Doesn't have to be bad, though. Like, maybe... the extra queen that I'm gonna get out is gonna be helpful in the defense or whatever. Now let's start that hive instantly. Oh, the hive is two. For some reason, I thought it was 150 minerals. I feel like that's one of the things that I always forget, just like how expensive like a hive is, and honestly, a lot of other random Zerg things. Yeah, well, look at his changeling just chilling here. He's probably just making more cyclones, right? Yeah, I think he is. You know what? I'm gonna go for the burrow. Just because that's going to help me later on in the game, I think. Like, if I ever want to have, like, a good amount of... Wait, he made another Reaper. I kind of like that, actually. That's pretty smart. Not going to lie. I would have never expected a scout to come down here. So that is well done by him. Guess I'll just use these to kill. I'm also going to be spreading a little bit of creep. Not my usual favorite activity, as you guys know, but... I do think when we're going to be going up against a mech playstyle, it would be nice to at least see... Either see where the Cyclones are going, or be able to... force a lot of scans, right? Like, forcing scans is always going to be quite nice. I do want to play a little more economical than I usually did, because otherwise I'm not going to be able to, afford a lot of Ultralisk, right? So, yeah, when is Burrow going to finish? Not quite yet. I also want to make a Nidus. Yeah, I guess I'll put the Overseer on top. I did see a third command center there. I didn't notice that until now, so that's good that I see that. I'm going to put one Ling over there. And then the rest of the stuff, I'm going to be burrowing. Oh, I do like this setup, I have to say, guys. I do really like this setup. The only thing is that I don't have enough Ling... Wait, what the hell is... Oh, that's a lip page. I didn't even see anything. I was like, is that a Cloak Banshee that I didn't see or something? Okay, so I lost a couple drones there. Not the biggest deal ever, but it is a little annoying. Especially because my economy already kind of sucks. I can probably kill that at some point with my queens, but I also don't want to get an inefficient trade here. Oh, that looks good. Yeah, we're going to get a little damage on that. Very nice. That's what I want. And then these, I'm going to burrow them. I am definitely afraid that I don't have enough Zerglings yet, though. Like, it's really not a killer Zerg. Like, if there's enough Cyclones going over that, even though, it should be a good trade for me. What the hell is that Hellion doing? Okay, that looks so freaking weird. I was like, what the hell is going on here? Okay, I'm going to lose one drone. I'm just going to be rebuilding these drones. I'm going to get the Ultralisk upgrades first. Guess I'll just move more over here, like even more links. I'm going to burrow one here and maybe one on the third. Oh, no, he probably has the third by now, to be fair, but I can always... Let's see, I'll check first. I don't want to burrow in front of him. No, exactly. Okay. If I burrowed in front of him, that'd be... Wait, where the hell did my queens go? No, it's Mark with his queens again, guys. Here, I'll get to the side. I will be able to kill this if I micro this properly, at least, so that's nice. There we go. I always lose. I should really start hotkeying these things, you know? It's not my thing for some reason, but at some point I got used to it, I promise. I also put one queen too many. Wait, should I just be making drones now? Because I was kind of expecting... Like, I've been paying attention to my opponent moving out all this time, but he just hasn't really done anything. Okay, now he's trying to take that base at least, so I guess we'll see how that's going to go. Now, I guess getting both of the upgrades before I start making Ultralisk would be a good idea. I hope he doesn't have a freaking Raven, by the way. Like, if he has a Raven, that's going to be pretty awful. So here's Ultralisk number one. I do have the Nidus. He doesn't know I have a Nidus, so that's one thing I need to keep in mind. I could also, like, wait for him to move out and then send the Ultralisk in. Like, I don't think that is the craziest idea ever. Gonna make a bunch of spores. Okay, so he finds my Overseer. Doesn't matter that much. Well, it matters a little bit. He's even making turrets and stuff. Like, this guy is... He is preparing for everything, I think. Here, I'm gonna spread those around a little bit. Let's see. Did he click on one of them? He didn't. He's making ghost. Okay. Wait, he's going for super fast ghost to deal with my... I mean, pretty cool, to be honest. He's going for super fast ghost to deal with my Ultralisk. Maybe I should just be going for more burrow. Yeah, I'm going to make a lot of upgrades as well. Yeah, this game is really... I don't think I've played a game like this before. Like, genuinely, I don't think I have. Because it's just... I've been waiting for him to attack me. He was playing, like, super scared. And now, because he was playing super scared, I don't even feel like I'm in a great position anymore. I'm going to make a couple infestors. I don't think that could be nice. Okay, wait, now he's going for it. Ooh, that does look like an army. I'll need my freaking... Okay, dude, for a second, I thought he scanned. Oh my goodness, I was like, what the hell? Okay, can it's a big bio army. Yeah, you know what? I think I'm going to go for Banelings instead. Let's see, I'll unburrow them in front of him and run into his base. I think that is a decent idea, actually. Here we go. I'm going to just attack this base fully with everything. It is a completely exposed base as well. Yeah, this is going to be a close one. I need all my queens here, I think, so I can transfuse these ultras. I mean, he's going to try to save a couple of these. Oh my god, this is so good. I can probably burrow a couple, actually. I'm just hold positioning the rest. Let's see. Okay, I got a couple burrowed. Yeah, he did pay attention, but it is going to force a scan once again. And that was really freaking nice, guys. All right, now wait. Can I? No. Oh my god, wait. This could be the play of plays of ultimate plays. Get... No! Wait, are you stuck? Are you kidding me? How are you stuck there? Oh my god, that is not cool. No, he came just in time! Oh, that is not freaking cool. I was gonna have the coolest play of all time, guys. I was gonna burrow these ultras. Oh man, that would have been so freaking hype. But see, I'm still gonna try, though. I'm gonna burrow all these ultras. Now I wish I kinda had my queens to put some injects again, to be fair. Let's see. I mean, if he ever walks into that, it's gonna be so cool. Like, really, that would be the coolest freaking thing ever. Okay, so he's over here. I guess... Wait. Guys? Come on. Come on. Get over here, my friend. I know you want to. Please, I need to see this. The fungal plus the Ultralisk unburrow is just something I have to see. Like, I really do. I need to see the freaking burrow, like, the Ultralisk unburrow plus fungal combination. I'd be so happy. Like, I've spent this entire game playing stupid. Like, do this one thing for me, my friend, please. Okay, I think he was coming a bit closer, right? He's playing so passive. He's rooting my... This would be literally my coolest moment. No, what? Okay, well, that is a scan. All right, then. I see how it is. That is a freaking scan. Okay, he's going to try to keep with the ultras here. I think I can just go across with my ultras now because he... Well, he does have a little bit of ghost energy, to be fair, but it's also not that much. I really should have brought an Overseer for this, huh? That would have been quite nice. Let's see, I think I'll just put a Nidus down here. Gonna rally in that. Gonna bring an Overseer, make the speed upgrade as well. For the Overlords, that is. There we go. Okay. I still have a Fungal, so that's quite nice. Let's see. He does have a massive wall. That's a little annoying, actually. Okay. Oh, there's gonna be a really big Fungal. Nah, not quite good enough. I'm gonna burrow one Ultra to see if he scans it. Is this the... Yeah, okay. It was a 1 HP. Oh my god, that fungal's so massive. These ultras are gonna get in here now. Look at the damage on these ultras. I don't even have upgrades, by the way, guys. This is 0-0 ultras. Look at this. This is freaking beautiful, isn't it? These ultras are absolutely just slicing and dicing, even through the ghost. I have another flanking ultra over here. I'm gonna send one ultra into the natural as well, if I can, just to attack the ghost. That would be quite nice. I mean, the SCVs there are already gone, and it looks like we're still gonna be able to push through with the Ultralisk trap. And this game, this was just freaking weird. Like, I don't know how else to say it. This was probably the weirdest game ever. I imagine that he probably saw my Ultralisk burrow and he was waiting for a scan or something, because he scanned right on top of them. Unless he was just throwing down a scan for no reason where there was no creep. That seems very questionable, so I don't think that's what happened. But what's funny about this game is that I felt like we were ahead playing Ultralisk Rush just because my opponent never attacked me. I spent all my money in, like, the highest quality unit that I have, which is the Ultra. Like, if you look at the game here, sure, I forgot my upgrades and I had to... I still don't know how does an Ultralisk even get stuck here, guys. Like, from an egg? Or like how does that even, well, it doesn't matter. But I didn't even get upgrades. But just the fact that we have like the same economy, but I'm making pure ultras where he's on 32 Marines. Like, I think this was freaking awesome. Now, this game didn't go to my expectations whatsoever. Like, normally, I feel like I'm pretty good predicting what's going to happen. Here, I had no idea. First of all, I just kind of assumed he was going to play mech because he even played mech against Protoss, which is the matchup it's worst in. Then he started playing bio, and then he suddenly had a freaking ghost. And even when I saw the ghost, I still thought it was ghost mech. But yeah, this game was freaking insane. Kind of blew my brain a little bit, but it is what it is. Let's go to game number three.
Game number three is against Koala, a Zerg player. All right, so we had Hydras against Zerg. Well, one cheese that I did really enjoy against Zerg was going for the Swarmos. It's just kind of hard to say that it was very good, right? But it was pretty fun. Now, we did play against Koala before, I believe. I kind of have a feeling that I played him off stream when I was practicing a little bit. I think that's what happened, most likely. I could be wrong. I do remember his name, but I think it was that, so I don't quite remember what his MMR was. He's probably around the same as my Zerg MMR, I think. Maybe like 5-2 or something. I guess we'll see. Now, I think another cheese that I also like is going for the Mutas. Like, the link drop opener into the Mutas instead of the Hydras is also quite cool. I think at some point, or no, that was more against Protoss, right? We also figured out that it's pretty good to get one evolution chamber to get melee upgrades for the Zerglings. So I can actually defend things properly without having to cause an enormous amount of chaos. Like, the last game was also one of those questionable games where, you know, if I didn't manage to cause so much chaos, like if my opponent just, let's say he had a bunker at the third with like a Hellbat or two, so I couldn't get that really big Zergling run by in, and then he just attacks me straight up without being distracted, it's probably a way, way different game. Like, it really is, you know, a lot to thank for the chaos that I can make a lot of these miracle games happen, right? Because that's where I thrive. Let's see, I'm going to go for the hatchery this time on time. Last game I was a little bit too late, I believe. The first game we... Oh yeah, no, I did get to do the link drop. I was thinking we didn't get to because we did kind of get stopped. I think we also lost one overlord to the queens. But we did still do a lot of damage and might even have been the game-winning move to get the one Zergling drop into the main base. I can see both overlords coming across. Looks like a very normal opening from my Zerg opponent here. I still haven't researched it, by the way, but I'm still pretty sure that you can see that by like how many overlords they have at what time and stuff. And since he had them at the same time as me, I think it's at least not a 12 pool. It's probably a hatch first, but it's at least not a 12 pool. Now this is... it kind of looks like my hatchery timing, right? Yeah, to me, this looks like a normal pool first, which I didn't know people played like that in ZVZ. Or is it like a fake fast hatchery with a link flood? Like, it's definitely not a 12 pool. Or do you... No, you don't make an overlord that fast. No. It's definitely not a 12 pool, but it is something a little weird. Like, it looks like a pool first to me, but then at the same time, there's not really... You know, it's six Zerglings. Do I have to be afraid of six Zerglings? I don't think I do. Let's see if I can do some micro. There we go. Got one Ling already. That's quite nice. I do think I can make two more drones because I skipped them for a little bit. Now I'm just going to be chasing those, get my overlords in position. And I would say this is probably a really nice start for me. Like, I don't know if there's anything I really have to be afraid of now. I'm going to start a wave more of Zerglings. He does see my overlord going to a little bit of a suspicious spot, I suppose. So maybe I should have thought about that a little more. And I mean, not like I could have known where his overlord was going to be, right? But still. Now, the plan is to go Mutas behind. Mutas are a little more gas intense than Hydra, so I'm going to add the second gas a little faster. Let's see what his response is going to be. Okay. Oh, so it is a link flood. Are those Banelings? No, they're just links. Okay. Well, at least... Like, the thing is, I think he has the same amount of drones as me, but it's just so hard to tell what he really has. I'm not going to morph the... I'm not going to morph the overlords yet because I feel like... Oh, I'm going to win that trade as in this. I feel like he is just going to be making Zerglings instead of walling off. Now, he's backing off, though. So, I'm going to still try to do it. Let's see. Okay, he's attacking me once again. I do have enough Zerglings. I wonder if he would realize if I just snuck out 16 links. Like, he probably would, right? I'm going to try it. Here we go. I mean, they're just suddenly going to appear into his main base. That's the thing. He did see those sneak out, I believe. So I'm just going to go up here, get the drones to safety, and then use my queens to defend. Let's see. He might still not expect me to arrive into his main base, right, with these overlords. He's probably rallying to the front. Here we go. I do have my two queens. It is really scary what I'm doing here, though. Like, I have to be super, super careful. So these are going to be... in the main base. I'm gonna run out with these to
to see if I can do anything. I think a couple of those. No, actually, none of those. Never mind. Okay, here we go. I am into the main base, and he's going to be very surprised here. I'm going to be able to snipe the first queen already, which is great. Maybe I can even get the bailing nest, actually. I'm just going to go for the bailing nest straight up, guys. Here we go. I did hold position a couple of these, I believe. Yeah, so the bailing nest is going to die. That's going to be really nice for the future. He is now going to send all the links into the main, and I can take a really good position over here. Do need to make sure to back off a little bit until these next links arrive. Here we go. I have enough links over here, and I'm just going to end up getting a really big surround on all of his zerglings. Look at that, guys. His bailing nest is dead. The bailing nest would be the ultimate counter here, but he cannot morph any bailings. I bet he's probably really sure. I don't think I can guarantee you guys. This had never happened to him before. He has never had his bailing nest sniped by a freaking Ling drop, all right? That's just 100% a guarantee. Yeah, let's see how many drones I can kill. I mean, he doesn't have drones. Okay, here we go. He had a couple bailings out on the map. I managed to split against the bailings that he did have. Oh my goodness. Pause, rage quit, and there we go. What a beautiful ZVZ cheese, guys. I bet he was probably really far out on the map. Morphing bailings, exactly. These were all the bailings he could morph before his bailing nest died. And if you look at his gas, he could have morphed one more at home if he was in time. So that would have been a pretty big deal breaker, because one bailing could kill 20 zerglings. You have to be super careful. But here, the Ling drop worked again. And I think this is the first time the Ling drop worked against someone who was also all-inning me with zerglings, because usually that was our weak point. That's why we lost a couple games against Zerg, where I'm trying to do the Ling drop, but then they're just Ling flooding me, and I spent all this money making a Lair and Overseers. But here, I think we played it perfectly. Like, we got a lot of damage in the main. We denied the bailingness, and then we converged on his army, got the surround. His bailings were on the other side of the map, and that was it. Now, we did play three games. I do think we still have a little bit of time, so let's go for a fourth one. Game four is against Lamo again. All right, so the Ultralisk build was definitely a success. So we've done Hydras and Ultras against Terran. So which unit is next for this game? I guess Swarmos wouldn't be a bad idea. I do think in the last game, the opening with the Zerglings was a really big success. I mean, you can't rely on getting that amount of success every game. But for that reason, I am going to go for the Zerglings again. Going to send two Zerglings around, followed by about 16 Zerglings with speed later on. Now, I would imagine, like, it's always a little bit difficult, a little bit tricky to play builds against a player that you've done it before, especially when it was this recent. Like, it was literally, the last game wasn't that long, right? It was like 10 minutes ago or something. So, I mean, it's going to be very fresh in his mind. And I guess we'll see. Now, something I did, oh, guys, hold on a second. Something I didn't do in the last game was actually go for the Ling drop. But my opponent opened with two Cyclones. I think it was two or three, but it doesn't matter. Like, he made Cyclones from the reactor, and 16 Zerglings in his main would absolutely annihilate two Cyclones. Like, two Cyclones have absolutely no chance against 16 Zerglings, not even close. If he would micro perfectly and pull his SCVs around it and hide them behind, then different story, right? Then the Cyclones are pretty good against the Zerglings. But if I, like, let's say I drop over here, the Cyclones are going to spawn from the factory over here, I surround them, I could very well win the game right there. I think I delayed my hatchery again by the exact same amount of time that I did in the first ZBT against him. So at least our builds are going to look consistent to him. So that's great. I just said it once, apply too late. Not really supposed to make that drone before. Yeah, I guess I'm going to scout the natural with this one. I do still want to get a little bit of scouting done, of course. I do need to hide a second Overlord out of vision of the Reaper if I can. Not quite sure if that's possible, actually. I mean, if the Reaper jumps down this cliff and goes over here, then it is going to see my Overlord. I also don't want to mess around with timings. I don't want to, like, hide the Overlord for 5 seconds and then blah, blah, blah. Because then before I know it, I forget to send my Overlord to the Ling drop spot, and then it's never going to arrive, right? So let's not do stuff like that. I'm just going to send it directly over here. This is going to be a nice place to hide for now. Reaper is finished as well. And I guess I'll just send the Zerglings via this path. Gonna send the Overlord here directly. Now, I do need to remember that he did do a good job scouting. Like, in the last game, he lost his Reaper. He actually made a second one, which is a very rare move. But also a very cool move, to be honest. Like, very, very cool. So now he's gonna do, I'm doing the same build. He's not gonna see the Lair yet, but he'll see it soon enough. Like, I know from the last game how he played, he's definitely going to be scouting that soon. He scouted my base very thoroughly. That's probably the most impressive thing about the gameplay, actually. Like, he really scouted very well, I have to admit. There we go. Now he's going to check. I could probably kill this Reaper, actually. It's a little risky to do this, though. But I'm going to go for it anyway. He's going to try to go for a juke. Let's see, can I get that? Oh, he did micro perfectly. Oh, I think neither of us micro perfectly, but it ended up working out for us. So that's great, right? So not necessarily fair for him, but that's how it happened. Now, I did forget to send my Zerglings here because I was so focused on... I could kill a Marine again, right? I think I'm going to get the Marine again, guys. No, Lavo, not again. It's very close, actually. I'm barely going to get... Oh, good micro by him. I was 100% sure I was going to get it, actually. Or well, not 100% sure, but I was pretty confident. So well done by him. And now I guess we're going to see... if he is going to go for the two cycles. Like, I really hope he is, guys, because this could be an absolute banger. Now, I'm going to make a gas first. I think I'm going to go for the infestation pit. I'm just not sure yet, to be honest. I think it's going to be the infestation pit, but I'm not 100% sure. I would like to go for Swarmost. Okay, here we go. He sees it now with... well, actually, I think he barely doesn't see it with that Marine. Okay, here we go. I kind of want to go just as the Cyclones finish, right? But I'm not quite sure if I'll find them. Oh, it's going to be Hellions this time. Here we go. I'm into the main base. That's definitely going to surprise him over here. This is going to really take a lot of his APM here, I believe, guys. Like, he's focusing on the Zerglings over there. But there are Zerglings in the main, killing so many freaking workers already. He needs to be really careful because I can surround those Hellions. And I will if he lets me. Oh, he's going to fight with the SUVs. Oh, okay, I love seeing this. Look how many freaking workers are dying, guys. He's losing pretty much every single worker here already. Oh my goodness, this was way too much of a success. The freaking Ling drove, guys. I think I'm just gonna go for the Spire here, to be honest. And maybe I can even do a follow-up Ling drop. Now, I do need to make sure to not get carried away, because his amount of Hellions does beat my amount of Zerglings, right? So if I lose all of these Lings, all of a sudden, I'm not gonna have anything to defend anymore, and that would be a little problematic, you could say. Now, he does see the Overlords are still here. Maybe I should be making drones instead. Like, I guess if he attacks me with the Hellions, he will probably die back at home to the Ling drop. So, Yeah, it's not easy here. Like, I would like drones, but it's also pretty scary, right? Here, I'm just going to send these Lings over to the front. You guys go mine gas so I can make 5 million mutas. That sounds like a great plan. This is going to be a pretty good distraction, by the way. If he does have Cyclones now, like even two, that would be pretty tough to deal with. It's a really good move, though. Look, he's going to have the Hellions over here, exactly. And then the Lings are over there. Oh, my God. And now the best part is that he's going to think he was tricked. But there are actually Zerglings over here as well, guys. Look at this. He's going to lose the Marines now. And then... oh, no, that's splash damage. Those middle line own his own freaking, what was that? His own freaking SUVs. That is quite painful. And now the Spire is already finished. Let's see. I can probably surround his Hellion, actually. This Hellion, he's being a little brave with the Hellions over there. I'm just going to switch it over to this Overlord. Guys, I'm already making 7 mutas. He has 3 Marines without upgrades. This is just another typical case of the Ling job being the best freaking distraction ever, together with the plays you can make. Now, I can't believe how freaking effective this build is in Grandmaster, guys. Like, this is, you know, the best Xerxes that I've ever done. It may be not the coolest one. Like, definitely, though, some of, like, the Ultralist rushes and whatever have probably been the coolest one. But this is freaking awesome. Now, he's going to see the Mutas fly into his base. And I think he needs to be a very strong, you know, mentally strong individual to not leave the game as he sees the Mutas fly in. I'm going to go in here with the Zerglings just to see if there's any Widow Mines. Doesn't look like there's any Widow Mines. Here come the Mutas, guys, and he is not going to be happy. I can tell you guys that much. Oh, my goodness. There is one Widow Mine over there. That is what I expected. He might have another one. I do need to be careful for a potential other Widow Mine here. But these Mutas are going to kill these Marines just fine. There we go. Oh, there is one more. I could probably just kill it before it shoots, right? There we go. That's going to die. Now I have all of these Mutas in his base. GG has to be called. And Xerxes to rank 1 is freaking art once again. Like, this was just freaking brutal, man. Like, I didn't play perfect. I didn't expand in time, to be honest. I didn't even micro the first 2 Zerglings properly, right? Like, I could have sent in those in way earlier, maybe denied the command center again. But these builds are just so freaking awesome. I feel like this episode alone probably added another episode to the length of this series, because this was just too clean. Like, there's no way I could stop right now after this, right? But I'm tired. Those were some awesome games. Hope you guys had a fantastic time. If you did, make sure to get a video, like, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see y'all for the next video. Adios.